Hello and welcome to another Roblox tutorial. So in this video, we're going to be talking about if statements and logic. So basically, what an if statement is it's a crucial code structure that uses logic to determine outcomes. So in this video, we'll be going in depth all about if statements, how you can use them, where you can use them, and just how they work. So I hope you guys enjoy. Make sure to like and subscribe if you do, and let's get right into it. So I'm going to go into server skip service and create a script. And I'm just going to define a simple if statement. So an if statement basically consists of the word if and then condition, then, and then you press enter and it'll automatically do end. So basically, how an if statement works is it's like a crossroads or like a junction. There's multiple ways where it can go. And the way it determines what thing to do is by the condition. So let me define a variable and call this condition. So condition, if the condition is true, so condition equals true, then the code inside of the if statement will run. So I'm going to print ran. So it checks if condition, it evaluates condition. So condition we defined is true, then we print ran. So if we're to run this, you can see it print ran. Now, if condition were false, it wouldn't run. So, this is all good for explaining, but in reality, you almost never just use a Boolean value and then have a condition variable. The way it usually goes is using logic statements. So, let me give you a quick example. So, 1 is less than 5. This is a simple logic statement that uses this operator right here with the less than operator. It basically says if 1 is less than 5, then you print ran. And that's obviously true, so it prints ran. And you can also put variables here. So let's say I have local var 1 equals 1, and then local var 2 equals 5. If I put var 1 here is less than var 2. Same numbers again, so it should be ran. And this works for all types of like basic math operators. So greater than works, greater than or equal to, this is less than or equal to works, and then greater than or equal to. So these are all the ways to do it. And then there's one other thing that you can do, is it's checking if one value is equal to another value. And you may think that you just put a normal equal sign here, but you can see it has an error. And this error is it like you th it thinks that you're defining a new variable. So the way that if statements work is you have to use a double equal sign to compare two values. So if var 1 is equal to var 2. And that's obviously false, but if I were to say set var 1 to 5, it'll be true. And so this functionality for if statements also carries on to the Roblox world. So if I were to go back into my script and create a base plate variable, so local base plate equals game.workspace.baseplate. Whoops, spelled that wrong, base plate. And I could compare base plate dot transparency to var 2. If I were to run this, you see it wouldn't run. But if I were to compare baseplate.transparency to 0, so it's completely opaque, it will run. So that's just something to keep in mind. It works for all data types, wherever. So if you remember from earlier, I told you that an if statement is like a junction. So this if statement that we have right here only has one condition and one outcome if this condition is true. Now there are certain keywords in Lua that allow you to change this functionality. First one is else. So basically what this means is it checks if condition. So if this condition is equal to true, this line right here, then we run this. Else, so if this condition is not equal to true, then we run this and we'll just print not true. So basically, one of these code blocks right here will run. Both of them will never run. That's one thing to keep in mind when using an if statement. So if I were to run this, it prints ran. And if I were to change this to, let's say, 1.5, there we go. It would print not true because the logic statement returns false. But then, let's say you have multiple conditions that you want to check for, and you still want to keep an if statement, you'll use a keyword, else if, one word. So this is the same thing as if, just in the same code block. So if I say else if base plate dot transparency equals 0, then so basically what will happen here is I can print else if whatever. What will happen is it'll say only one of these will run. And if it meets this value, then this will run first. If it meets this value, then this will run. But if they're like the same value, then it'll ignore both of these and just go to this one, obviously. So let's set this to 0 just to show you that it works. Let's play this. You can see it says else if. And you can chain these for as long as you want. So I can put as many else ifs as I want, and my if statement will still work perfectly fine. So let's say you want to check if a value is not equal to another value. The way you do this in Lua is by using the tilde and the equals key. So this checks if baseplate.transparency is not equal to 0.5, and this is true, so it runs it, which is great. Now, the only other real big thing you need to know about in regards to your if statements is the keyword not. So what this basically does is, let me just demonstrate up here, is if I print not true, it'll print false. And if I print not false, it'll print true. So this basically inverts the value of a boolean. So if your variable is false, it'll make it true. If it's true, then it'll make it false. And this is very, very useful in regards to logic. So I can check if not baseplate.transparency is not equal. Actually, to make this easier, we're going to change this to equal. So it'll check if baseplate.transparency is equal to 0.5. If this is true, then it'll make it false. But if it's false, it'll make it true. So right now it should be false. So if we run this, you can see it prints our first block in here. And the reason I have parentheses here is because whenever you're using not, you really want to put parentheses around your condition before you negate it. So that's about it for this video. I hope you guys enjoyed. It was pretty short, but if statements are very useful and you will use them all the time. So make sure to comment down below any questions that you have about this or any suggestions. And like and subscribe if you enjoyed. And I hope you guys have a nice day, and goodbye.